When there's trouble, you know who to call. KC! Hey, when there's a show really bad. KC! Sorry, I really like the song, but terrible rain lyrics sometimes. But yeah. Let's just start the video. What is up, guys? It's me, Case, here of your Kids with Kids shows. Now, if you don't know me, I'm a DC fan. I love them all. Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, the Justice League, all that good stuff. I am especially a fan of the Teen Titans and their hit TV show. And, well, I didn't watch the live-action version of the Titans, but I wasn't really that interested, but it seems pretty good. You guys recommend the show, please let me know in the comment section below on how good it is, or if you recommend it or not. And thank goodness we at Titans only had two TV shows. Only two TV shows! Two TV shows! Anyway, today I'm going to celebrate the original Teen Titans show with the top 10 of my favorite Teen Titans episodes. And now, let's get started. All right, Titans, go!
Number 10. Only Human.
Now, this episode was pretty fun. And, well, it's my favorite Cyborg episode. It shows him trying to struggle being a half-man, half-human superhero. And we saw it before and after this episode. But I think this episode did it a lot better. It shows that Cyborg does have limits, but he can move past them in spite of him being half-robot. And now, that is Cyborg for ya. And he also stands by his friends in spite of the odds stacked against him. And of course, he taught that smug robot Atlas a lesson. Booyah! Next number.
Number 9. Switch.
It's a Freaky Friday superhero episode. And, well, I like how Starfire and Raven try to work off each other's differences and try to use their powers, but through their emotions. We see both sides how to handle their emotions, while Starfire's powers are fueled by joy of free emotions, while Raven's powers are fueled by, well, try to control her emotions, I should say. And this showcases that. So you go, girls! Next number.
Number 8. Date with Destiny.
In this episode, we get to see what happens when you make Starfire either really mad or really jealous. Or both. Yeesh. Okay, all joking aside, this was a pretty fun episode. It shows that Robin's willing to do anything to protect his friends and his city. Okay. And that even means taking a supervillain's daughter to a date to junior prom. Okay, then. Anyways, as we all know, Robin and Starfire's relationship in the show and in the comics, but me personally, I'm more like him to be with Batgirl, so I'm more of a Robin-Batgirl shipper. If so, makes me wonder, if the show lasted a little longer and had Batman and Batgirl in it, how do you think Starfire will react to the female Kid Crusader? Probably not well. Next number.
Number 7. Betrothed.
Much like in the previous entry, Starfire is willing to do anything for her friends, ever even her own planet, Tamaran. And, well, this showcases that too. And she even willing to go through marriage in order to save her own planet. And as she forced the marriage little scratch by her current queen and sister, Blackfire. Of course, it turned out to be a trick. I'm not going to spoil it for you guys, but see for yourself and you'll be kind of surprised. Or, well, not so surprised if you watch the show as long as I have. But anyway, yep. Starfire loves her planet Tamaran, but she also loves her home planet on Earth just as much. Next number.
Number 6. Haunted.
Okay, you guys know it, and I know it. Slade, aka Deathstroke, is one of the most awesome villains in this show. In fact, one of the most awesome various periods in the whole DC universe. And well, having him go in the previous season of season 2 was kind of sad, but hey, we got this episode that came in the third season. And of course, Robin turned up the crazy factor in this episode. Woo! And well, a slave and a ghost? Now that's scary. Yes, I know in the show they called him Slade because they want to make it child friendly. Personally, that's just dumb. Not to mention that Mayhem is an evil genius when in comics he's supposed to be a mercenary and assassin. So, yeah. So, going to call him Deathstroke. Next number.
Number 5. For Real.
Now, I wasn't exactly too thrilled about Titans East. And I figured they're just there. They didn't do all that stuff that was important. Especially in season 4. But they're just there and they're barely mentioned again. Until this episode came out and they were back with a vengeance. And Bumblebee, Speedy, Aqualad, and Mossy Middles was shown that they might not be the OG Titans, but there are plenty of good. And, well, there I want to take a Control Freak, which is, well, of course, one of my favorite villains of the show. And, of course, this is my favorite episode of his appearance. And so, yeah, he's a crazy fanboy with a soup up the mook. How petrifying. I love this guy. Next number.
Number 4. Calling all Titans and Titans together.
This was the final two-part in the show, and it was pretty awesome seeing all the Titans go against all the show's villains. Well, almost all of them. Some of them weren't there, like Slade or Blackfire or Trigon. Yeah, but I ain't complaining. Oh, especially Blood Blood, but whatever. But, again, I'm not complaining. And this was still pretty awesome seeing the Titans working together against a common major threat, the Brotherhood of Evil. And that's pretty awesome, to say the least. Next number.
Number 3. The Apprentice, Parts 1 and 2.
This was the first ever two-parter in the show, and it is glorious. And, well, it showed that Deathstroke is willing to do anything to get an apprentice. And, well, Robin was his first choice. And, well, he also was able to blackmail him into becoming his apprentice, whether he likes it or not. And Robin trying to find his best way to find a way to get out of Slade's control. So his friends are willing to save him. That drew to litigation right there. And of course, Slade suffered his most humiliating defeat in the hands of the Titans ever. Wow. It's gonna be hard to top a two-part like this. Oh wait, they did. Next number.
Number 2. Aftershock, Parts 1 and 2.
This episode, along the ones that came before it, is loosely based on the famous Teen Titans comic book storyline, The Judas Contract. I give this show major credit for basing a very dark Teen Titans comic on this kid-friendly show. Though, there are some elements taken out here and there, but you're going to watch this episode, along with a few others that Terra appear in it, and read the Judas Contract to fully understand what I'm talking about. Anyway, hey, I'm not going to spoil it, and so let's just say it doesn't bode well for Terra. And that's really too bad. Terra was a pretty cool character in the show. And, well, sadly, never got to star again. Well, we sort of did, but that's another story. Next number.
And before we get to number 1, let's take a look at a few honorable mentions. And the number one Teen Titan episode is... The End, Parts 1 to 3.
This episode was built up immensely in Season 4, and it paid off. Wow. Now the Titans are going against the DC version of Satan, the Devil. Woo. And that's pretty awesome on its own. And, well, I'm too speechless for words how great this final part was. Or, well, it should have been the final part of this series. But wasn't, but whatever. It was solely focused on Raven, and probably one of best of Tara Strong's performance. And this is just paying out awesome. I'm not going to spoil it for any of you, but check it out for yourself. You'll see what I mean. In the writing, the animation, all of it. And check it out for yourself. And now on you, this is how you do a Teen Titans show. Anyway, that's all for today, and let me know in the comment section what your favorite Teen Titans episode is, and see you all next time!
Farewell, friends. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and DeviantArt.